Well, good morning or good afternoon, depending on where you are. Thank you very much for joining us and welcome to episode 6 of the itSynergy Hacking the Human Security Series. And today we are going to be talking about updates. So let's jump right in and get started. So a little bit about itSynergy. Let's talk about our why. And our why we do what we do, is creating positive experiences with technology. And so if you think about how it felt the first time maybe you got like a new cell phone or saw a new gadget for the first time, or maybe you installed an app on your phone and you said to yourself, wow, this is really cool. That moment is a positive experience with technology. And we do what we do in order to create that feeling with the people that we work with. That's what gets us out of bed in the morning. So why are we here today specifically? Well, in 2014, IBM did a study that found that 95% of all security incidents involve human error. CompTIA, which is an industry association, followed it up in 2015 with another study where they found that human error accounts for 52% of the root cause of security breaches. And then also in 2015, Experian, the large credit reporting agency, found that employees and negligence are the leading cause of security incidents, but remained the least reported issue. And so our goal in the next 14 minutes is to give you some quick action items to help you be security smart and not be one of these statistics, not be the cause of a breach in your environment. And I would encourage you to join us on the second Thursday of every month. We're here at 11:30 a.m. Arizona time for a new 15-minute topic. So let's jump in. Today's topic is updates. So why are we talking about updates? Well, there have been a number of studies over time that have attempted to estimate the percentage of computers that are fully patched. And the studies have various findings. They all come out with various numbers, but they generally range between 2 and 5%. And so what that is saying is that only somewhere between 2 and 5% of all of the computers out there are actually fully patched at any given time. In 2013, InfoWorld, which is a technology publication, did a study and estimated that 80% of malicious attacks could be prevented by patching just two products, Java and Adobe Acrobat Reader. So if those two products alone were fully patched, forget everything else, their estimate was that 80% of the malicious attacks could be prevented. And then in 2015, a company named Secunia, which is an update scanning software, published a list of the top 10 most unpatched programs. Now, the interesting thing about that particular list is that neither the Windows or the Apple operating systems made the list. So a lot of times when people think about installing updates, they think about, if you're on Windows, I need to install my Windows updates, and if I'm on Apple, I need to install my iOS updates. But as it turns out, although that's good, and we're going to talk about that today, and it needs to be done, neither one of those things were on the top 10 list in terms of what was causing breaches and what is unpatched. On that top 10 list, interestingly enough, Apple has two of the top 10 slots. In fact, they're the top two in terms of Apple applications. QuickTime and iTunes were the top two unpatched applications. Adobe has three out of those top 10. And Microsoft products show up for the first time on that list as number 9 and number 10, with a couple of versions of Microsoft.net in those two spots. And so one of the things that's interesting about that particular statistic to me is that a lot of times people who operate on the Mac platform tend to go with an assumption that, well, you know, there aren't really viruses for Mac. I don't really need to worry about updating Mac as much, etc. But in fact, we find out that that's not really the case, and PCs in this case actually are lower on the list than a lot of the Apple products. So the real important question here is, why do you care? What difference does it make? Well, it's the unpatched vulnerabilities in software programs is how the bad guys get the best of you. So when you click a link maybe you shouldn't have clicked, or get an email and read it maybe that you shouldn't, or open a file that you shouldn't, etc., one of the first things that the bad guys are going to try to do through the software that they're installing is they're going to look for things that are unpatched. They're going to look for programs that are unpatched. And if those programs are unpatched, that means that there are things that the bad guys can do to take advantage of the flaws in those programs, which you have not yet installed, which can then allow them to do what they want to do with your computer. And so that could be things like capturing your personal information, recording your keystrokes in order to get a hold of your passwords, activating your video camera. I mean, there's all kinds of nasty things they can do once they get in. And the way that they get in oftentimes is through an unpatched vulnerability. So you say, okay, I get it. I'm in. What do I need to do? Well, the first thing you need to do when it comes to patching is you need to start out with an inventory. So before you can even start patching, you've got to figure out what all is out there that you need to patch. And so there are a number of categories that you should think about when you're making this inventory list. So of course, we've got to think about all of the programs that are installed on your computer. So maybe you've got, you know, Microsoft Office, maybe you've got a Chrome browser. I mean, there, you know, there's all kinds of things that could be installed on your computer. So you've got to make a list of all your programs. You've also got to make a list of the plugins for your browser. These are little programs that work along with your internet browser, like an Internet Explorer or Google Chrome or whatever else. And so those need to be on your list as well. If you're running any type of antivirus or anti-malware software, or maybe you're even running a couple of different types of that software, you need to make sure to list those. Of course, as we talked about earlier, you have to consider your operating system. So if you're running on Windows or running on Mac iOS, Mac OS, you need to consider those. You also need to make sure that you're adding your phones, your tablets, and other mobile devices to your list as well, because we're going to talk about those too. Those need to be patched. And in addition, not just the phone or mobile device itself, but you've also got to think about the apps that you have installed on those devices, because apps have patches as well. And then finally, you need to think about hardware devices. What are we talking about when we're talking about hardware devices? We're talking about all of those things in your technology world which are connected somehow to the network or to the internet. So do you have baby cameras? Do you have a router or firewall at home? Do you have maybe like a Nest thermostat that's connected to the internet? So all of those things as well need to be on your inventory list. So once you've made that list, the next step is to divide and conquer. And so you need to take that big long list that you've just made of all of these things and divide it into four distinct categories. So number one is devices. So these are physical things, you know, the phones, the thermostats, the routers, all those types of things. The second is operating systems, because there's a specific way that we patch those. Next is applications, and so put that into a category on your list. And then finally, mobile. And so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go through all four of these categories and talk about what you need to do in order to ensure that you're patched and that everything is up to date. And I'm actually going to go through them in reverse order just to keep things interesting. So number one, let's talk about mobile. There are a couple of things that you need to think about when it comes to mobile devices. You need to patch the mobile device itself. So if you're running an Android device, you need to patch the Android operating system. And if you're running an Apple iPhone, you need to patch the iOS. And then in addition, you also need to patch all of the applications on those devices as well. So let's start out with an Android device. And if you happen to have your phone right there while you're watching this, you can actually follow along with me and do this as we talk about it. So on your Android phone, you're going to want to go into the settings. And then in settings, you're going to want to go through that list and find the choice that says about. And then once you get into that screen, there will be a choice that says update. And so what you want to do is you want to go into that update screen, and if there is an update available, you want to install it. Now, it's also a good practice just to check every once in a while, because your phone should prompt you if there's an update that's available, but just in case maybe you're busy at the time and you ignored it, you told it to go away, whatever, and now you've forgotten about it. So it's also a good idea just to go in and do this every once in a while, to go in and check that update screen and see if there's anything that's available for the phone. And then the next thing we need to do is the apps. So on Android, you're going to go into the Play Store. And then you're going to go into the menu, which is like three little horizontal bars at the upper left side of the screen. From the menu, you're going to choose My Apps and Games. And then in that screen, there's a button that says Update All. And that will update all of your apps on your phone as well. On the Apple platform, if you have an iPhone, you're going to go into Settings on the iPhone, and then General, Software Update. And then you're going to click to download and install the software update. Again, good idea, you know, Apple will generally remind you if there's a software update available, but just in case you were busy and you ignored it, whatever else, good idea to go in and check this every once in a while, make sure that there are no updates available for you. And so that's how you'll update the iOS. You also need to go to the App Store and click on Updates, and then hit Update All on that screen, and that will update all of the apps on your iPhone. So the next category is application. So this is all of the programs that are installed on your computer. So Microsoft Office, Adobe Acrobat, Java, QuickTime, iTunes, all that kind of stuff that you've got installed that you've made a big long list of. And so there's a couple of ways you can do this. So I'll talk about the free way first is you can go to Nynite.com. Nynite is free for home use. And it's an awesome utility. We use it for all of our customers. We use the professional version. So you go to Nynite.com. I've got a little screenshot of the website over there. You select all of the apps that are on your list. So you've made this inventory list. So you're going to select all of the apps that are on that inventory list. And it's hard to see in this screenshot, but if you go to the website and you could even go to it now, you'll see they've got well over 100 applications that are on their list of applications that they patch. And so you just need to check a box next to the ones that you have. And then once you've checked the box for all of the various applications that you have, there's a button at the bottom of the screen that says Get Your Nynite. So you're going to click Get Your Nynite, and that's going to download a little file to your computer, and you're going to install that file on your computer, and that will go out and update all of the apps that you have checked in one fell swoop. So this is a far easier way to do this than going into each application automatically and going to the help menu and checking for updates and whatever else. This Nynite, which is free for home use, will allow you to just hit everything all in one shot. And so this is a great thing to do on a regular basis. I would say I'd like to have people do it weekly, but at a minimum, let's do this once a month. Go out and check this site and download and install these updates. Now, you notice this is a fairly manual and somewhat labor-intensive process to go through and check all these boxes and download and install. They do also have a professional version that can make things much more automatic and schedule the installation of updates so that you don't have to do it so manually. But that does cost a little bit of money. So if you don't want to go through this manual process, then you can buy the professional version. If you'd rather not spend the money, you can just go out and do this once a month and everything will stay up to date. So the next major category that you need to make sure is updated is your operating system. So if you're running on Windows, you can click Start and type Windows Update in the search bar. And then one of the options that pops up will be an option to install updates. And so you can just click that option to go ahead and install your updates. And if you're running a Mac, you just click the Apple icon in the upper left corner and select Software Update. And that will go and install all of the updates that are available for Mac OS. The next category is, or the final category is devices, and what I'll say with that is that's a little bit more complicated, how to update, you know, your routers, your cameras, your Nest thermostat, all that kind of stuff, and so that's actually going to be the topic of next month's webinar, and so we'll dive into that deeply and show you exactly how to update all of those next month when we talk about the Internet of Things, which is the topic of next month's webinar, and I will circle back at the end of this presentation and talk about how to sign up for next month's webinar if that's something you're interested in. And then finally, a bonus tip that wasn't on the categories that we talked about earlier, but you'd also need to make sure to update, is your antivirus and anti-malware software. Now, you may just be running one of these, you may be running more than one of these, but either way, you need to make sure that that stuff is updated. And so those companies generally release updates very often, usually on a daily basis, at most probably every other day. And so you've got to make sure that you're getting those updates and that you've got the latest updates for all of your antivirus software. The other thing that we see is a lot of times people will get a computer that maybe has a 12-month trial of their antivirus or a 30-day trial of their antivirus software. And when that software expires, they forget to renew the subscription or to pay for the subscription. And so if you are using a paid version, go into that antivirus software and make sure that your subscription is up to date, because if it's not, you're not going to be getting updates anymore. And so that's very important. And then finally, you want to check the settings area of that program to ensure that those updates are set to happen automatically. You probably don't want to go in and manually download these updates on a daily basis, because that's fairly often. So what you want to do is set the program to do it manually, or excuse me, to do it automatically, and then manually go in and just check it maybe once a month, once every couple weeks, something like that, just to make sure that it is automatically updating like you're expecting it to. So with that being said, I will thank you for attending today. Our next webinar is January 12th. Again, these are always the second Thursday of every month at 11:30 Arizona time. The registration is now live, so you can go right now to itsynergy.com/webinar and sign up for next month's webinar. Our topic next month is going to be the Internet of Things. So we're not only going to talk about what is the Internet of Things and help you understand a little bit when people talk about the Internet of Things, what they're talking about, but much more importantly, we're going to teach you how to be safe and keep your Internet of Things devices secure and updated. And so that will be the topic next month. If you have any questions for me, there I am, and there is my email address. Please feel free to reach out. And if you know anybody who could benefit from these free 15-minute webinars, I would love to have them join us as well. So you can email info@itsynergy.com, and we will reach out to them and make sure they are on the list. So thank you very much for joining. I hope you have a great day.